Good morning once again. If it's your first time here, my name is Irvin.
大家早上好。如果这是你一次第一次来这个教会，这是 Irvin 弟兄，我是约翰弟兄。
Now today is a really special day for our church family because after 2 years of wandering in the wilderness,
今天是一个特别的日子，因为我们漂泊了两年之后。
We have finally entered the land that our God has given to us.
我们终于进入了上帝所赐给我们的土地。
Now we definitely would not have been able to make it if not for our God and the faithful men and women that He has raised up. Not only faithful men and women, but also children. And not even those within this church family, but also those outside this church family who contributed to this building project with their finances and their prayers and their love.
如果不是耶和华的恩典，以及神在这个教会家庭兴起的老老少少的弟兄姊妹，甚至不在这个教会敬拜的弟兄姊妹，用他们的时间、心灵和财富支持建造神的殿，我们绝对无法走到今天。
So let's give all the glory to our God and show our appreciation to those whom He has raised up to build His house here at PP.
让我们将所有的荣耀归给我们的上帝神，并向他并向那些他兴起来的 PP 这里的弟兄姐妹表示感激。
All right. Now today is a doubly special day because this is the day known to many as Easter Sunday, or more accurately, Resurrection Sunday, where people all around the world gather to celebrate the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ 2,000 years ago.
今天也是一个双重特别的日子，因为这是被称为复活节的星期日。这一天在世界各地追随耶稣的人聚集庆祝他2000年的复活日子。
So on that special day, 2,000 years ago, whether it was 29th March, 31st March, or any other date, Jesus was restored not to walk in oldness of life,but to walk in newness of life, where he would sit at the right hand of the Father, ruling over all creation.
在两千年前的这一天，无论是3月29日或其他的日子，我们的主耶稣被重生，不是回到被钉死之前的旧生活，而是进入了一个新的生命。在那里，他坐在天父的右边，统治着所有的创造物。
So I'd like to invite everyone this morning to say with us what the early church said.
我想邀请大家一起宣告，就像早期的教会一样。
Christ is risen.
基督复活了。
He is risen indeed.
他确实。复活了。
Amen. Now this morning, I'd like to lead us in a meditation of what the resurrection meant to the early Christians and what it means to us today and every Sunday and every day of our lives.
今天早上，我想带领大家思考以下两点。第一，耶稣的复活对早期的基督徒意味着什么呢？第二，对我们今天的教会，每一个星期天意味着什么呢？
Now let's take a look at Romans chapter 6 verses 1 to 4.
请跟我一起翻到罗马书的第六章一到四节。
Now as you're flipping there, the letter to the Romans is the Apostle Paul's way of looking at the Israel story through the lens of the resurrection of Jesus.
在这里，使徒保罗给罗马人的书信，是他重新讲述以色列故事的方式。
You see, oh sorry, go ahead.
是关于耶稣的复活。
You see, in Romans chapter 5, he talks about the Israel story of life and death from Adam to Moses.
在罗马书的第五章，他谈到亚当到摩西的以色列生死的故事。
And in chapter 6, he arrives, as it were, leaving Egypt behind and standing at the waters of the Red Sea.
到了第六章，他说到 埃及的奴役和红海的故事，听他怎么说。
What shall we say then? Are we to continue in sin or slavery to sin that grace may abound?
这样怎么说呢？我们可以仍在罪中，叫恩典显多吗？
By no means, how can we who died to sin, how can we who left Egypt and that old land behind still live in it?
断乎不可,我们在罪上死了的人,岂可仍在罪中活着吗?
Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death?
岂不知我们这受洗归入基督耶稣的人是受洗归入他的死吗?
We were buried therefore with him by baptism into death in order that
所以我们借着洗礼归入死和他一同埋葬
Just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in not oldness of life, but newness of life.
叫我们一举一动有新的样式，像基督借着父的荣耀从死里复活一样。
Isn't that amazing?
太神奇了，不是吗？
Paul is telling his readers, you remember Jesus' crucifixion and resurrection?
保罗告诉他的读者们，你们记得耶稣被钉在十字架和他的复活吗？
Well, it wasn't just about the death and life of one person.
这不仅仅是关于一个人的死亡和生命。
It wasn't even just about the forgiveness of your sins, important as that is.
这不仅仅是关于个人的罪被饶恕，虽然这是很重要的。
It was actually about something way bigger, something that happened before Jesus was born. That's right. It was actually about the Israel story of the past, where they passed from their old life in an old land into a new life in a new land.
这是关于以色列过去的故事，他们把在埃及的旧生活留在过去里。 进入了一个新的土地和新的生活。
But that's not all.
但这不是全部。
Because Paul continues in verses 5 to 8, saying,
因为保罗在第5到8节继续地说,
For if we have been a past tense, united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be, future tense, be united with him in a resurrection like his.
这是一个过去时的句子。我们若在他死的形状上与他联合，也要在他复活的形状上与他联合。
His resurrection becomes our resurrection.
他的复活也变成我们的复活。Now
we know that our old self was crucified with him in order that the body of sin might be brought to nothing.
因为知道我们的旧人和他同钉十字架，使罪身灭绝。So
that we would no longer be enslaved to sin, for one who has died has been set free from sin.
叫我们不再做罪的奴仆 这样我们就可以不再生活在旧土地上。
Now, the Apostle Paul says, and here's the important part, if we have died with Christ, past tense, we believe that we will also, future tense, live with him.
刚才录了第七节，因为已经死的人是脱离了罪。我继续第八节，我们若是与基督同死，就信必与他同活。这是将来时的一句话。
Now, Jesus' resurrection wasn't just about the life and death and life of one man.
耶稣的复活不仅仅是关于两千年前一个人的死和生命。
And yes, it was about something that happened way earlier, something way bigger than Jesus.
是的，这是关于耶稣出生之前发生的事情。
Yes, it was about the story of Israel passing from old life into new life.
这是关于以色列的过去的故事，他们把在埃及的旧生活留在过去，进入了一个新的土地。和新的生活。
But that's not all.
这还不是全部。
Because it was also about something that was going to happen.
这也是关于将要发生的事情。
It was about the future story of the people of God.
这也是关于我们未来的故事。
Where the people of God would become a new people, living a new life in a new promised land.
在这里，神的孩子作为新的人，在新的土地上过新的生活。
Isn't that amazing?
这不是很神奇吗？
Paul is saying that when you and I truly believe in the resurrection of Jesus,
保罗说，当你我真正相信耶稣的复活时，
we will not only cherish how he came back to life 2,000 years ago,
我们不但会珍惜他两千年如何的复活，
but we will also see how he breathed new life into our past,when we didn't even know that he was there with us.
还会珍惜他如何在我们甚至不知道的时候为我们的过去注入了新的生命。他的确在我们的当中。
Paul is saying that when you and I truly believe in the resurrection of Jesus,
保罗说，当你我真正相信耶稣的复活时，
He will continue to breathe new life into our future. He will be there with us.
他将继续为我们的未来注入新生命，他将会在我们的当中。
So my brothers and sisters, what do you hear from the word of God today?
我的弟兄姊妹，今天早上你们从神的话语听到了什么呢？
Do you hear the story of a resurrection that happened 2,000 years ago and then was frozen in history?
你们听到的是两千年前发生的复活故事，然后就在历史中冻结不动了吗？
Or do you hear the story of a resurrection whose power flows backwards, restoring your past, however broken it may be?
还是你们听到的是一个复活的故事，它的力量向后流动，恢复你的过去，无论它是多么的破碎。
And then flowing forwards, restoring your future with all your hopes and your dreams.
然后向前流动，恢复你的未来以及你所有的希望和梦想。
For me, I hear the story this morning, not just of Israel, but of this church family.
对我来说，今天早上我听到的故事不仅仅关于以色列国，而是关于我们教会的家庭。
For we too were a wandering people with no home for 2 years.
因为我们也曾经是一个没有家的流浪子。
We too longed for a new life in a new space that we could call our own again.
我们也曾在流亡中徘徊了两年, 从一个地方搬到另一个地方。
But this morning, if we are honest with ourselves, perhaps there was something more that we longed for.
我们也渴望在这座建筑得到上帝赐给我们的新生活。
Perhaps beyond the rebuilding of these facilities, we longed for the rebuilding of our identity as a church family.
或许除了重建我们的设施，我们也渴望重建我们在教会家庭的身份。
Perhaps beyond the renovation of brick and mortar, we longed for the renovation of our hearts as a church family.
或许除了实体的改造之外，我们更渴望心灵的改造。
Perhaps we long to live the new life that only He could give.
或许我们渴望新的生活，只有神可以给到的。We
longed to become a new people.
也许我们渴望成为新的人。You
ever felt that before?
你们有没有这样想过呢？这样感觉过呢？
Well, today I want to end off this message by sharing something very personal, and I do hope that it will be okay with you.
今天我想分享一些非常私人的事情，来结束今天的话题。这可能会有些敏感，所以我希望你们可以接受。Today
I stand before you as a minister of this church family.
今天我正在你们的面前，作为一个教会家庭的一名教师。
But it was as recent as a few years ago that my wife and I longed for a new life.
就在几年前，我和我的妻子渴望有一个新的生活。
We longed for the rebuilding of our identity as a church family.
我们渴望在教会家庭里重建我们的身份。
We long for the renovation of our hearts right here.
我们渴望我们的心灵得到翻新。
We longed and we longed for a new life with God.
我们渴望有一个新的生活。
Now we did not find it then.
那时我们没有找到。
And our hearts turned heavy.
我们的心变得沉重。
And we wondered, as many of us probably have at some point, whether PP was the right place for us.
我们在想，可能在某个时候，许多人会想过的 ，PP是适合我们敬拜的地方吗？
Was this where God was calling us to raise our family and our children?
这是上帝。 呼召我们建立家庭和养育孩子的地方吗？
We long to grow. We long to live a new life. We longed to become a new people.
我们渴望成长，我们渴望过新的生活，我们渴望成为新人。The
grass looked greener on the other side.
草原。 在另一边看起来很绿。
And so we started to wonder, what if we explored the other side?
所以我们想，如果我们探索另一边，会是怎么样子的呢？
And it was around that time that a brother shared with me that the grass is always greener where you water it.
就在那个时候，一个弟兄和我分享说，草原总是在你浇水的地方会更绿。And
that, along with other things that God revealed to us in that season of discernment, led us down a journey we did not expect that brought us here.
加上耶和华在那个季节向我们显露了其他事情，让我们开始了一条我们意想不到的道路。
You see, where we prayed for God to change certain things in our church family and beyond, God first changed us.
我们祈求上帝改变我们教会家庭中的某些事情，上帝首先改变了我们。
Where we prayed for God to breathe new life into certain areas in our church family, God first breathed new life into us.
我们祈求上帝在我们教会家庭的某些领域注入新的生命。上帝首先在我们的身上注入了新的生命。
Where we prayed about leaving, God called us to stay.
我们祈求离开，上帝呼召留下来。
And not only to stay, but to stay and water the grass.
不只是留下来浇水。
So this morning, do you too long for a new life?
今天早上，你是否也渴望有一个新的生命？
Do you too long for God to grow and transform you, your family and this church family?
你是否也渴望我们的神改变你，改变你的家庭，改变你的教会家庭，和让大家一起的成长？
Well, if you do, then cling to him. Don't let go.
你是否也渴望有一个如果你愿意，那就紧紧依靠他，不要放手。
Stay and water the grass.
留下来浇水，让你的草地更绿。
Because this place could be a garden for your family.
这个地方可以是你的家的花园。
This place could be your home.
这个地方可以是你的家。
For your children and your children's children.
是给你的孩子，你的孩子的孩子。
This place could be our home together if we water the grass with living waters.
如果我们用活水浇灌草地，这个地方可能是我们的家。
And when we do, my brothers and sisters, God will pour His life-giving Spirit into us and resurrect us, not as our old selves, but to become a new people, because that's what resurrection is all about.
当我们这样做时，我的弟兄姐妹们，我们的上帝会将赐予生命的圣灵浇灌在我们的身上，并使我们复活，而不像我们以前的旧我，而是作为一个新的人，因为这就是复活全部的意义。
You see, Jesus was not resurrected to resume his earthly ministry, but to move on to sit at the right hand of the Father.
耶稣复活不是为了继续在地上的事工，而是为了前进，坐在他天父的右边。
Jesus was raised not to remain in the tomb, but to go forth to the peoples of Jerusalem.
耶稣没有留在坟墓中隐藏，而是被举起，在这地上的子民中行走。
And Jesus was restored not to walk in oldness of life, but to walk in newness of life.
耶稣复活不是为了在旧的生命中行走，而是为了在新的生命中行走。
And so will we.
我们也将如此。
My brothers and sisters, our old building died its death.
我们的弟兄姊妹，我们的旧建筑已经走到了它的终点。
But today, this new building is raised in its place, not for 1980s, but for 2024.
而今天这建筑，这建筑在复活中被提起，不是为了80年代，而是为了2024年以上。
This building is resurrected not for us to resume our old ways, but for God to commission us to new works in this world.
这座建筑在复活中被提起，不是为了我们继续我们的旧方式，而是让上帝派我们做新的工作。
And this building is restored not for us to remain hidden behind its gates, but for the nations to stream in from near and far.
这座建筑在复活中被提起，不是为了我们隐藏在大门的后面，而是为了让万国万民通过通路。
So come.
来吧。
So come all you who are ready for the resurrection of this church family.
所有预备好的。我们教会家庭复活的新人。
Won't you rise, all who are ready to taste the newness of life?
请站起来吧，所有预备好要尝试新生命的人。
And won't you sing the people of the risen King as He restores us?
我们来歌唱吧，所有属复活之王的新人，让耶稣恢复我们的我们成为
a new people
新的人。
Come, people.